My Minnesota Guardian Application. My Minnesota Guardian, or MMG, is a system that allows court-appointed guardians to submit their personal well-being reports and the Affidavit of Service electronically. MMG is an easy electronic tool for preparing, reviewing, and filing annual reports and encourages timely and accurate filing of personal well-being reports and affidavits of service. In this module, guardians will learn how to submit their personal well-being reports and affidavits of service, amend reports, request contact information changes, and sign up for email or text notifications. Agency administrators will learn how to set up administrator accounts, give staff access, and assign and reassign cases to staff. Process overview. First, the case is loaded into MMG. In order to submit a report, the case must be loaded into MMG. Court staff will enter the letters of guardianship into a case management system, which initiates the creation of the case in MMG. If you find a case you are looking for is missing, contact court administration to load that case into MMG. Next, the guardian files the PWBR and Affidavit of Service. Once the case is loaded, you will be able to access and file the Personal Well-Being Report and Affidavit of Service in MMG. Then, court administration reviews and accepts the Personal Well-Being Report. If court staff see unanswered questions, they will send the guardian a deficiency notice and the guardian will have 14 days to submit an amended report. If court staff see an area of concern, they will send the report to the judicial officer to review. The guardian then amends and resubmits the personal well-being report if required. Finally, court staff accepts the amended personal well-being report. If you file your PWBR on paper or through EFS, the information will still be transferred to MMG from the case management system. Before you get started, you will need a My Court Min account to use MMG. For instructions on how to create an account, go to www.mncourts.gov. Click on Help Topics, Guardianship, and select the MyMNGuardian link. Click on the Training tab. Here, you will find My Court MN instructions, as well as other MMG resources. If you are a guardian working for a professional agency, you will need to wait until your agency administrators add you to their account before creating a My Court MN account. Logging in to MMG. To log in and register your first case, select the Set Up an Account tab and click the MyMNGuardian link, or go to https://mmg.courts.state.mn.us. Click Sign In. Enter your My Court MN account email address and password and click Log In. To register a case, enter the person subject to guardianship's case number and the anniversary date. Click Register. Once the case is registered for agencies or guardians, all the cases associated with them in the court's case management system will be in MMG. This is your My Dashboard page. Click the logo to return here from any other page in MMG. Use the Guardian Account drop-down to review or edit contact information. You can also go here to sign up to receive email and text notifications, change login settings and passwords, and sign out. Reports due displays reports due in the next 30 days. Previously submitted reports display under the Reports History tab. Cases display under the My Cases tab. Notifications from the courts display under the Notifications tab. Click here to complete the personal well-being report. Click here to complete the affidavit of service. Guardians who are also conservators can click Go to My MN Conservator to go to their MMC account. Filing a personal well-being report. To file a personal well-being report, go to the Reports Due tab and click Complete Well-Being Report. The personal well-being report is set up like an interview. You will need to complete all 19 questions on the report. After each question, click Next or click Save and Complete Later. If you answer a question, and another field displays asking you to explain your answer in more detail, enter the reason why you said yes or no. Once you've completed all 19 questions, click Review. If an answer needs to be changed, use the menu drop-down to go to a specific question. Click Proceed to continue, or click Back to the report to go back. Review the report, and click Submit Report. Sign and submit the personal well-being report. If you are the only guardian, enter your name. If there is a co-signer, answer the yes and no questions and enter your name and co-signer's name. Then click Submit. Click Download Report. Click Open to open the document and print, or click Save to save the document to a folder on a computer. The report you downloaded will include the Personal Well-Being Report, Annual Notice of Rights, and Bill of Rights. You must serve all of these documents on a person subject to guardianship, formerly called the ward, and any interested persons of record with the court, unless an interested person has filed a waiver of notice with the court indicating they do not wish to receive copies of reports. After you have done this, go to your guardian dashboard and fill out the Affidavit of Service form. After serving the person subject to guardianship, complete the Affidavit of Service form. Completing the Affidavit of Service. After you serve the person subject to guardianship and other parties, submit the Affidavit of Service. Click Reports Due. Click Complete Affidavit of Service. Complete the information shown here. Enter the guardian name, the date of serving the person subject to guardianship or mailing date, the method of serving the person subject to guardianship, and the location you serve the person subject to guardianship. Indicate whether any interested person of record with the court were served the documents. If yes, click Add Interested Person. And fill in the requested information. Finally, check the box to declare under penalty of perjury that everything you have stated in this document is true and correct. Click Submit. You can download the Affidavit of Service to save or print. A success message will display. Click the My Minnesota Guardian logo to go back to My Dashboard. Reviewing and amending the Personal Well-Being Report. You may review or amend your reports from the Reports History page. To review the Personal Well-Being Report, click Review or Amend. The reports can be filtered by date. If you received a notice of deficiency from the courts regarding the person subject to guardianship's Personal Well-Being Report, you may need to send an amended report. To amend the report details, click Review or Amend Report. Click Amend Report to make changes. Click No to go back to the report details. Or click Yes to continue to amend the report. Use the question menu to go to a specific question on the report. Make the necessary changes to each question. Click Next. Once you've completed all 19 questions, click Review to go to the Review section of the report. Review the report and click Submit Report. Click Proceed to continue or click Back to the report to go back. Enter your name to sign the Personal Wellbeing Report. Then click Submit. Download the amended report to save or print. Serve the amended PWBR, Annual Notice of Rights, and Bill of Rights on the persons subject to guardianship and interested persons. You must serve all of these documents on the person subject to guardianship, formerly called the ward, and any interested persons of record with the court, unless an interested person has filed a waiver of notice with the court indicating they do not wish to receive copies of reports. After you have done this, go to your guardian dashboard and fill out the Affidavit of Service form. After serving the person subject to guardianship, complete the Affidavit of Service form. Requesting contact information changes. You can request changes to contact information for yourself or your person subject to guardianship in MMG. To request contact information changes for yourself, click Guardian Details. If you have multiple profiles in the Minnesota Case Management System and they are listed here, make sure to request a contact information change on each profile. Click Edit. Make all necessary change requests. Click Request Changes. A message that the request was successfully sent will display, and Pending will display on your profile page. When the request is accepted, the pending message will be removed and the details will be updated. Click Guardian Details to go back to the details. If the request is rejected, click Notification to view the reason for the rejection. To request a contact information change for your person subject to guardianship, click My Cases. Click the case number. Click Edit Person Subject to Guardianship Information. Make all necessary change requests. And click Request Changes. A message that the request was successfully sent will display, and Pending will display on the Person Subject to Guardianship Information page. When the request is accepted, the pending message will be removed and the details will be updated. If the request is rejected, click Notifications to view the reason for rejection. Signing up for notifications. You can opt to receive email or text notifications in MMG. From the dashboard, click on Guardian Details and click Select to enable email notifications or Select to enable text notifications. You will receive these notifications 30 days before the personal well-being report is due, 15 days before the report is due, 30 days after the report was due, if overdue, and 7 days after the report was submitted, if the affidavit of service was not filed. Tools for agency administrators. The following section applies only to MMG agency administrators for professional guardian agencies. If you are a guardian, you may stop the video now. In this section, you will learn how to set up administrator accounts, give staff access, and assign and reassign cases to staff. This is the My Dashboard page for agency administrators. Agency cases display under the All Cases tab. Click here to add employees and assign cases. Adding employees and assigning cases. Click Employees. Administrators must set up a MyMN Court account before adding employees. Click Add Employees. Add the employee information. To assign a case to an employee, Select a case and click the arrow. The case will move under the employee. To assign all cases, click the double arrow. Assign the employee role. An employee can complete and submit personal well-being reports and affidavits of service. A company admin can add employees and assign and unassign cases, as well as completing and submitting reports. The active employee status defaults to active. Click Save, and a success message will display. If a message displays that says the email address already exists, this means the employee already created an account. Submit a technical support form under Contact Us on the public website. Editing employee information. To edit an employee's name, unassign cases, and change their role or status, click Employees. Click Edit. Make any necessary changes to the employee's name. To unassign a case, select the case and click the arrow. To unassign all cases, click the double arrow. To change the employee's role, select the new role. To mark an employee as inactive, click here. Click Save to save your changes. For more information about MMG, visit www.mncourts.gov and select Help Topics, Guardianship, MyMNGuardian.